Rocket League was sitting in my update queue yesterday afternoon, so I decided to look into the patch notes and see if anything interesting was being added. I saw a couple of things, but... Wait, what? A new beta feature for remapping controls through Steam? Could this mean Steam input API support? I'd never wanted an update to download so fast in my life. I booted the game up and went into the options to find a new drop-down menu. Use Steam Input Beta. Tears of joy streamed down my face as I realized my favorite game now has Steam Input support. Okay, so with that melodramatic anecdote out of the way, let's get into the actual thing. To enable SIAPI support, you need to make sure that this Use Steam Input drop-down menu is either set to auto or to your device. I only have my Steam controller connected, so my options are off, auto, or Steam controller. After that, you can either press the guide button and access SIC from there, or you can press the view change bindings button in the controls tab of the options. And finally, you need to apply the official Cyanix config. You can change it after importing it if you wish. I edited it to reflect my legacy config. But the real question is, how is it? SIAPI has a troubled past with many failed implementations, so it isn't like it's irrational to be a bit skeptical. The first 12 hours were rough. At first, controllers weren't working at all, not to mention that the official config was still a legacy config, so there wasn't any way to output as SIAPI. Late yesterday evening, the SIAPI config was uploaded, but the game wasn't accepting any input from SIAPI commands. However, I tried it this afternoon and everything appears to be working perfectly. Action sets are swapping seamlessly and the action lists are overtly complete. My past experiences with SIAPI is that devs either intentionally or accidentally left out features. Sometimes it's small, like Team Fortress 2 not having the next dialogue button for advancing a tutorial, and sometimes it's huge, like Grim Dawn not allowing the user to assign mouse cursor control. But this game has more actions than I need. In fact, I think it has more options than are in the in-game binding list. I mean, I can assign rotate camera left individually rather than just assigning a camera controller. The same goes for steering. I did run into a situation that I thought was going to be a deal breaker though. I prefer to have my right pad set to the single button input style and I use the entire pad for tap to jump. But single button wasn't an allowed input style for the right pad. Then I saw the context-sensitive label for the start button. It said Advanced Settings, where it used to say Legacy Settings. I found my single button input style and was still able to apply a SIAPI action to the touch binding. I'm not sure when this was changed, but the last time I tried something like this, it was called Legacy Settings and I had to apply a legacy binding as well. So this was a welcome change, even though it probably has nothing to do with Rocket League itself. I fired up practice mode and played around with that for a bit, and then I played a couple of online matches and even went into the replay editor to make sure it switched to that action set properly. I had zero issues during this testing. It's remarkable. Rocket League is about to be my gold standard for all other SIAPI supported games to be held up to, but I can't give it that mark yet since it isn't perfect. As of this video, it is currently missing glyphs. Not just some devices' glyphs, but all of them. While using SIAPI, I can only see mouse and keyboard glyphs in menus. This is mostly notable in the mid-game goal replay, showing a mouse button to skip the replay, and in a distinct lack of any glyphs in the main menu. However, the SIAPI support is still in beta, and it has been a slow rollout of features since patch time, so I would be surprised if the glyphs weren't fixed in the next few days, with the worst case scenario being that the glyphs aren't added until it loses its beta status. All in all though, I highly recommend trying this out. Even without the glyphs, this is still the best implementation of SIAPI in any game I've played and actually makes me hopeful for the API. Action set swapping works, I have every action accessible as a binding, and they gave us a really good SIAPI config with an action set for every single situation. As soon as the glyphs are added, I'll be making sure to voice my praise to Cyanix, and anyone who appreciates their decision to add the API should as well. SIAPI isn't exactly the most attractive controller API, and the lack of good examples doesn't help. But Psionics has given us an implementation that we can show off as SIAPI done right. And honestly, that is a huge chunk of ammunition to aid in getting more devs, and hopefully more players, on board. Excellent job, Psionics, and thank you.